I've downloaded high-res versions of those textures I was after. In fact, that's just and basically, I've made sure that these are reusable, license-free. So the first thing to do is what we want to make is table stuff. So I'm going to remove all this stuff. Sorry, the roulette wheel. So I'm going to remove all this crap in the middle. In fact, let me. I don't know if I can do that with GIMP. Let me leave GIMP running. We're going to open this as it's a JPEG with Paint because Paint is much easier. Oh yeah, there we go. Or is it? No, what am I talking about? Not MS Paint. Yeah, I should have opened it with GIMP. Right, there we go. So let's select. Sorry, some of my tools are off the edge of the screen. You're not really going to see them. That one. Right, now we can use the eraser to erase them or not. All right, I'll have to do this the hard way then. Come on, why aren't you deleting? Oh, I see. I really need to add an alpha layer to this because it's going to make I could just go over the bloody thing with an eraser. Although, why isn't the eraser working? Or is it the point is too small? Yeah. Oh, there we go. Be better if I could just select the things and no, not that one. How do I select everything but the roulette bit in the middle? There's got to be a way of selecting stuff. No. Did wonder how far I could go in with the erase tool before I'd start mucking up the texture I want to keep. Yeah. Bollocks. Make this smaller. I wonder, is there a selection method in GIMP that's like DR, where I can select one thing and then select everything but that, and then just nuke it? That'd be useful. Let me try that. So. No. Select. Invert. There we go. No. Seems not. Oh, there we go. Can I cut that out? Come on, you motherfucker. Delete. Oh well. There's clearly a much better, quicker way of doing this than the. Are you fucking kidding me? I still shit there. Let's select all. Control A, Control Shift, Control A. Okay. Okay, there's just a little one there. Oh, there's a bit down there. And there's a bit there still. Don't be a shit. No. Motherfucker. Oh, that's just GIMP being gimpish. Right, let me s change the image size on that to 2x2. So now it's 2x2. Export as, because you can't do a save as with flipping GIMP. Make it a TGA, and then we can convert it to a. I can't remember the name of the DDS afterwards. Come on, export. Really? You can't put the extension in yourself, GIMP. There we go. 700K. I can live with that. Right, let's do this one. Open with GIMP. Let's rotate it first. Gimp, stop being a shit. Right, where's rotate? Come on, give me the rotate image. Yeah, you know what? We'll just work on it this way. Hang on, what's that model like that I was looking at? Oh, it is that way. Happy days. Right, well, I don't really need to move anything from here other than just to change the... Although, you know what? Let's just see if we can remove the green background and then we can use our textured green background and have this as a decal. Sorted. Doesn't mean I have to go into every bloody square. And remove the green. But the end result will be a nice texture. Well, sorry, texture, a nice decal. Gotta love the numbers that don't have a flipping thing in there that I've got to pick up. Like that. Like the bloody sixes, 17s, lovelies. 18s, no. 15s, yes. 14s, no. 13s, yes. Sorted. Nice. Right, let's make this. I wonder what happened when I make this square. Break it so I can change the. I can't remember the name. What's the aspect ratio? Happy days. Where am I? I made it bigger. Oh well. I was gonna make it smaller. Right, there we go. Now our two little textures are decals. I'm gonna make them into decals. So, as I don't like making work for myself and have access to the SVN, although you don't need access, it just makes it easier in this instance. You go into material definitions. First thing I'm going to do is models, props, textures. Come on, give me my props. Come on, there's got to be one models, props, surely. Oh, there we go. Right, so that's the path that we're going to need to create. Well, that's easy enough. I'll leave that one open. But what we want is decals. So, textures, decals, and something that has alpha decals in it. Grime corners, blend filter, yeah, grime corners light, there we go. what's different about this one? I'm guessing it's the blend thing that gives it the transparency. Well, we'll soon find out. Right, so I believe that we don't need all that nonsense in the texture anymore. We just need from there upwards. So what we're going to call this, TDM brew. So because we're going to take two of them, we're going to call one wheel and one table. So all the textures I'm going to create for you so that you can see the thing in DR always have Ed on the end of it. Let me check. Yeah, we don't need. So we don't need specular or any of that nonsense, or a material type, which is what wood is. We can do that. Yep, and then that bit there. So I can dispense with all of that. Happy days. So there's our roulette table, and then we just change the table bit at the end for wheel. Now let me double check I'm spelling the word roulette properly, because my spelling is atrocious. Yeah, roulette. Two E's. Happy days. So there's our wheel, there's our table. And let's just double check I've got them in the right location. So models, dark mod, props, textures, roulette table, Ed. Now the way to do that is I'm just going to go in, and I've already got one over them open in here. Resize it, make it small, so because the Ed images don't need to be big, they don't need to be full resolution. So we're going to go scale image, and then I'm going to make it a 512 by 512. Export as underscore Ed. Job done. Close that. Discard changes. Do the same thing with this one. Well, that's probably going to look a bit crap in game, but we'll find that soon enough, and I can always change the files after the fact. There we go. So we've got our red sizes and our thingamabobs and our normal textures, decals. Grand! Right, let's get building. Let's check my dinner first. My dinner's ready, so I'll save this video here, but the next step that we're going to do is building the table now that I've created the material definition. So we're going to call save that, where are we? Save as I normally have mine biker dude Right. So let's, for shits and giggles, before I go, let's just open up that up and see if the decals are in there. Right. Let's pretend that's the surface of our table. It's probably going to be about that size anyway. So was that? You know what? Let's actually open the map up. All right, so first floor. So yeah, I wasn't far off with my table size. I reckon that's about the right size. Right, let's find green cloth. Where are we? Dark mod. Fabric. Happy days. Let's have that at a nice... excuse me. A nice scale. That's probably too high. Shrink that down a bit. No, it's still too high. You know, let's do a 2-to-1 fit then. Wrong 2-to-1. Let's try a 2-to-1 the other way. Grand. There we go. There's our plain surface. Create a decal. Go to textures. And see if I got lucky and did it right the first time. What would this be under? Probably going to be under FM, I'll bet. Let's try. Hey, look at that! That's what I'm talking about! Come on, apply it. Oh, love it! Ah, the fonts are all screwed up. I'm hoping... that is a result of the... that's only affects the ed file and not the... Right, that needs to be the other way around. Nice! How much space is the roulette wheel going to need? Is that perfectly... no, it isn't, is it? What are we talking here? That, there we go. Now, let's see if I can wedge that in there. Let's make this table a bit longer. Or I just make this a bit shorter. Nice! Right, create a cylinder. And it's going to be brass, and we probably need to up the divisions a bit. There we go. Come on, give me my gen brass. That's what we want. No, not gold. Jesus, he's not that rich. There we go. We're going to make it brass, no shadows. And then... nice. Let's extrude that. Nope. Control or T even. Nope. Control T even. Nice! Nah. Too much. Let's try that again. I'll try four. Let me have a look at my. That might do it. Right, so get rid of that, get rid of that. And oh, that's too tall, isn't it? And that bit needs to be wood as well. Oh, I need to cut a hole in the middle of the table, don't I? Fact. Let's do this. Do this right. Do it once. Do it right. Do it once. What are we going to make it out of? I think we'll make it out of that texture. Oh. Right, let's control T that. Call it two. Yes, and yes. Then I'll select that one. Then I'll control T that, and that'll be a minus three. Nope. Control D that. A three. Nope. Control T minus two. Get rid of that. Control I. What am I doing wrong here? Control T. Did I say two? Nope. Minus two. And what's going on here? You know what? You can't succeed, cheat. How deep has that got to go? I'd say it goes that much. Right. Let's select all the inners. Drop it down. Now, have I got a? Yes, I have. I'm going to split that. Ah, bollocks. You know what the problem is? These circles the DR creates aren't fully circular. So, before we go any further with that, let's just tweak it just a tad so that it become circular. They're like these, they're like slightly squished circles normally. I still might have to tweak this. But I think that looks more circular than it did before. Keep forgetting about DR. That's probably one of the things that would be from using proper modeling program. I get proper bloody circles. Let's just rotate that. No. Still not perfectly circular. Can't have a bloody roulette table spinning around and for it not to be circular. And Obs probably knows this is coming, but I'm going to ask him or maybe Greyman if they can create me a little script for this so that it'll go fast relatively quickly and then slow down gradually. There we go. Unfortunately, the divisions are a bit flipping off. And it's still not perfectly circular. I can hear Judith laughing at me now. Well, better than what it was. That's going to have to do. Because I think if I pull this in any more, let's just see. I don't think it will make a difference, but no. Right, where was I? We were creating thingamabobs. Bits to cover the gaps. So the simplest way to do that would be, in fact, while I'm here, let me get this texture facing the right way. Is that facing the right way? No! That's annoying. I want it to go from left to right there. In fact, that bit's going to be brass anyway. I wish that brass texture had some flipping texture to it. Like that. That's better. But I bet you it's pointing the wrong way. But you know what? I don't care. Because it kind of looks like the model I'm trying to mimic. Well, that can be tweaked. Right, so what I'm going to do is double that and then move it out to... In fact, I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to do is this. Go end cap. And then give it an inverted end cap like that to fill in the gaps in the table. Oh. Fine. blam. Then you just copy from there, paste onto that, and then copy that. Paste again so the texture matches. Blam! We have one hollow roulette table. Let's give it some more divisions though. So when the table itself is spinning, I don't get bits of it clipping, but I don't see holes through it. And then just because I think I'm going to have to make this table a bit thicker than it is. Travel eye to thing. In fact, am I even going to bother doing that? No, I'm not. What I'm going to do is that's just going to be the top. I will fill in the bottom later. Now, what we can do is what's going on? Why isn't it filling it out? This will be fun. I'll probably have to snap the edges of these two bits together. What am I missing here? Oh, that's what I'm missing. Right, let's do a select all the internal verts and then control G them, but let's pick a grid that's not going to cause it to snap all over the place. Come on, don't be a shit. I just need to pull it in. Perfectly snaps there, so why isn't it bloody snapping there? Oh, there we go. Grand, sort of. Still isn't bloody perfect. So it's those ones there that need to snap into place. Okay. Now, no, come on. I was going to say grand. But no. Stick it up your ass. How many spaces is it? 1, 2, 3. And how many is it there? 1, 2, 3. Grand. Right. Let's see if our roulette texture. Pastes into there neatly. No! Oh man, how am I going to make this fit? Ah, oh, I didn't think of this, did I? I'm an idiot. I'll have to make an inner cap, won't I? A That's what I'll have to do. No, that's not what I want to do. Shift C. Yes. Lovely. And then Control S. Nice. Now if I do fit. Wrong texture. Oh man, that looks crap. I suppose what I needed was that circular thing in a length. I don't know if I could have steered it out. Ah, bollocks. It was all going fine until then. Right, I'm going to have to think about this. But anyway, it's the beginnings of a roulette table. If someone can think of a way, what I'm thinking is that, not as a circle, but as a strip. Oh, I'm a dick. What am I thinking? It's the old DR fucking problem as usual. There we go. But that center wheel still isn't lining up because it doesn't have enough. There it does. Blam! It still doesn't line up properly. And it's not round anymore. That is a shocker. Well, round dish. I think I need to put a brass. Yeah, that ain't gonna fucking work, is it? Go back, come on, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. There we go. What I'm doing there is I'm selecting the front top face of the brush because I can paste that texture to a brush. Perfect. Then all I'm doing is making the brush the same size as the patch underneath. So when I do this, happy fucking days. I'm getting weird. Oh, it's because I've got something. Oh, you know what? I need to put a brush underneath this so I can see what the roulette table looks like. I guess I could lift this up by one. Clone it. I move that one down by one. And then the one underneath has a brass texture. Oh, middle click on any texture you want to copy to bring up in the texture inspector. Blam. There we go. In fact, yes, we need to get the texture to fit the model. Come on, DR, stop being a shit. That ain't gonna work, is it? Yeah. No, because there's no vert there to drag that bit out there out. Bollocks. I'm going to have to make the model of the patch smaller. Come on, DR, stop being a shit. Yeah, this would definitely be better in a bloody modelling program. Yeah, that's decidedly looking not square at all. Not square, not round. Now, if I create my brush again over the top to copy and paste it, it should hopefully. Yeah. Come on. Be closer to fitting. Nice. Almost. You can see how not round my patch is. Because the texture is rounder than the bloody patches. Oh, almost there. Oh, interesting. We've got those points now that I didn't have before. Or maybe I did, and they were hidden. Oh, man. That just beginning to bug me. Oh, fucking hell, Grebo. So help me. You've got to fix that. You know what? I think that'll do. Fuck you, DR. I'm gonna kill you, DR. Right, that's looking like a roulette table, isn't it? Let's clone this. Crate in here. I'm gonna be. I suppose I really want those things, but that texture, but without the numbers in it. Don't be a shit all your life. There we go. There's a simpler way of doing this than just dragging crap. Just do this. No. Oh, these all don't line up. I can fix that when I come back. Come on, where's that copper with the lines in it? Stop being a shit. That's what I want, but I don't want it not to be dirty. It needs to be shiny brass with lines in it. That's roulette-esque, I guess. Yeah, that's definitely not looking round, is it? That's gonna bug the fucking crap out of me. Trouble and bloody vert points too close to each other. It's a pain in the arse trying to select one. This is getting subtly away from me now. Subtly, it's getting away from me. better. I didn't realise that bit was out. Alright, well. Why is that bit so much higher? Right, one roulette table, slightly off round. Roulette wheel, I should say, sorry. Oh, there we go, I need to move that down one, don't I? There we go. Not really like the model. But don't have much of a choice, because I don't think we've got any other textures that'll do what we need, it to do. And that have little lines in it, unless I make my own texture, which I really can't be bothered to at the moment. No, I think we'd probably need an actual new texture. Ah, interesting. I could probably apply that texture to there. And see. How many divisions do I need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 40? Oh, 10 maybe. No, I think I'm going to have to make another version of that texture, but with all the numbers missing. Because if I try it this way, it's just going to look shit. Well, for now, that'll have to do. I mean, it's not far off. Just every now and again, one of the divisions is off. Anyway, what's the hell are we in this bloody video? Jesus, an hour.